In this video, we're going to take a look at Stage Manager on the iPad with iPadOS 26. This kind of takes the windowed mode that Apple introduced with iPadOS 26 up to a new level. Not only can we open up our windows or apps into windows, but we can also group them together. So we can have all of our productivity apps together on a stage. We can have all of our social media apps together on a stage. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at Stage Manager on the iPad. Let's go over to my iPad. Now, the first thing we need to do is we need to turn Stage Manager on. We do this through the Settings app. So I tap on it, and then we need to go to our Multitasking and Gestures. When I tap on that, we have our three different modes. Right now I'm in full screen mode. You can see we have the check mark there. If you want to learn about windowed mode, I have a separate video on that. And then in this video, what we're going to focus on is Stage Manager. Now, Stage Manager also incorporates all of the features that we have within windowed apps. So I like to think of this as a step up from windowed apps. When we're looking at or working with our apps in windowed mode, basically what we have is all of our apps that are in Windows on one space. What we can do when we go into Stage Manager is we can group those together, much like I said on the introduction. So I can group all of my social media apps together. I can group all of my productivity apps together as an example. So it kind of takes our windowed mode and adds an extra layer to it. So let's go ahead and tap on this to see how this all works. So I tap on it. I'm in Stage Manager mode. Now, the first thing you'll notice is not much change, just like when we went into windowed mode, if you watched the video on that. Well, actually, something did change. You're going to see in the lower right-hand corner here, I have a little grab handle. Basically, this is a window. It's just taken up my entire display. When I drag that, what I'm able to do is turn this into a window or make the window smaller and resize it. And now I'm looking at my apps in windowed mode. Now, if you're familiar with the windowed mode or watch that video, you'll notice that we have something extra over here. This is my Stage Manager. So this is where I can group different apps together. Basically, this is called your recent apps. And what we're able to do is group different apps together. So as an example, if I wanted to go to my app store, this is a recent app. I tap on that. I'm looking at my app store. I want to view my recent apps again. All I have to do is just flick to the right from the left edge. When I flick to the right, I can see all of my recent apps. So now I just tap on notes here and it's going to open up my notes there. I tap on Safari here. It's going to open up Safari. That's the basics of what Stage Manager is. And basically what we're able to do is we're able to group, and I'll show you how you do that, different apps together here. But before we do that, let's go and turn some of these into a window, because really that's how you're going to be using Stage Manager. So just like with windowed mode, when we're in an app, if we want to make an app into a window, we just tap on it. And then you're going to see a little grab handle here. When I take that handle there, what I'm able to do is make that into a window. So now we have that window there. I want to go back to my settings. I tap on my settings. I want to go to my app store. It's going to open up in full screen. I grab the little handle in the lower right-hand corner, and now it's a window. So now I'm able to easily switch when I put them into windowed mode. I can easily switch between all of my recent apps here. Let's make that one into a windowed mode. Stage Manager works really well when you put your apps into a window. All right, so now we have these different apps here. I said I could group them together. So let's say that I'm working on this is Keynote here. Let's say that I'm working on this Keynote presentation and I have some notes in here. So what I want to do is I want to group or take my notes here and open up a new window. Well, all you have to do is just drag this out, and now it's a window. Those are now grouped together. So let's go ahead and drag this one out here as well, and we can see that. Let's go ahead and make it a window here. We can see that I have three windows in there. So now I go back to Safari. I'm going to go and browse. I go back to Safari. It's going to hide or close those windows there, and they're going to be right over here. So now I want to go back to my Keynote with the notes. I tap on that. I'm back at Keynote. So let's go with the Settings app. I want to group this together with the App Store. So what I do is I just drag this out. And when I do, it groups those together. So now I can go to Safari, and then I can go to Keynote, and I can go to my settings with the App Store. And it's going to keep those groupings together. That's what Stage Manager basically does. It makes it really easy to group different apps together. So now, instead of having all of your open windows in one space, we can actually separate that out. So this could be productivity. This could be social media apps. This could be just browsing around. And this one here could be a different set of productivity apps that you're working with. So basically, all you have to do is just tap on those to show them. Now, you're going to see that my recent apps here is always showing. Well, basically, what it's set to do by default is it's set to automatically show and hide. So it's showing right now because there's space there. But if I were to move this window over to the left, watch what happens. They disappear. Same thing with the dock. The dock is set to automatically show and hide. So if there's space there, it's going to show. But if I move this window down, watch what happens. The dock disappears. So now how do we get the dock and those recent apps back? Well, for the dock, what we have to do is we just have to flick our finger up a little bit from the bottom. And we're looking at my dock. So I just kind of lift it up just a little bit. And if I want to see my recent apps, I do the same thing. I just swipe over from the very edge there just a little bit, and I can see my recent apps. So if you have windows that make our dock disappear or make your dock disappear, make the recent apps disappear, you can easily just flick to do that. You may want to actually turn this off. Maybe you want to have them hide all the time. They're taking up valuable real estate. I have more room for windows here, so you don't want to see those. Those are distracting. Well, you can easily do that in the Settings app. So let's go back over to my Settings group here. And when I swipe up, I'm in the Settings app here. You're going to see that I have automatically show and hide recent apps as well as automatically show and hide dock. And both of these are turned on. So that's why they're automatically showing. Again, I move this over to the left. It disappears. Dock disappears. I move in the lower left-hand corner and they both disappear. If you don't want to show those, what you do is you just tap on these, and you see I'm going to tap on them, and when I do, they disappear. So how do we get these back? Again, we just flick, and we flick, and we can get them back. But they're not going to automatically show. So if you want to have a little bit cleaner desktop area there, it's calling it a desktop like it's a Mac. If you want to have a little bit of a cleaner area there for your windows, you can turn these off. A few other settings that we have here are we can swipe to reveal the menu bar. If you're not familiar with the menu bar, when we put our app into windowed mode, we get a menu bar at the top. Basically, what we do is we just flick down and we have our menu bar. So I'm in the Settings app. That's why it says Settings there. And what I'm able to do is tap on each one of these menus and see the menu bar. And if I go over to another app, let's go over to this app right down here. This is the App Store. So now when I flick down, you can see I'm in the App Store. And now all the menus are related to the App Store. And we can even see keyboard shortcuts. Command 1 will open up Today. Command 2 will open up Games. Command 3 will open up Apps. So if you have a keyboard, you're able to use keyboard shortcuts with this as well. We can't have the menu bar show all the time. We always have to flick. But if you don't want to see the menu bar at all, what you are able to do is turn this off, and then it'll hide the menu bar. You're not going to be able to swipe to reveal it. Keeps the iPad just a little bit more simple. Still in our windowed mode, but we don't have access to that menu bar. And then we have 4- and 5-finger app switching. With 4- and 5-finger app switching, what we're able to do is switch between these different groupings just by swiping with 4 or 5 fingers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to swipe with 4 fingers, go over to the right. And you're going to see that these here will disappear. Actually, what they'll do is they will move down to the bottom here. And what's going to happen is this here will open up. So it's going to replace that. So now I swipe with four fingers. And we can see that my app store is down here. And now I'm looking at that next grouping. So basically what we're able to do is swipe between a different spaces here just by swiping with four and five fingers. I'm going to go back over to my settings app. We're looking at my settings app. So we can easily swipe between our different groupings of apps just by using four and five fingers. We also have productivity gestures. With productivity gestures, what we're able to do is double tap with three fingers to undo, pinch and spread with three fingers to copy and paste, things like that. If you don't use that, you can easily turn that off. And then we have shake to undo. Don't drop the iPad, but when you shake it, it's going to undo your last move. Maybe you made some text changes, shake it and it'll undo it. And then we have swipe finger from corner. I mentioned this in the windowed when I talked about the windowed mode. We can't use this when we're in Stage Manager. Basically what this allows us to do is swipe from the upper left-hand corner. We're going to do a screenshot. Swipe from the upper right-hand corner. We get to our quick notes. This only works in full screen apps. It does not work with windowed apps or Stage Manager. So if you like that feature, you're going to have to just stick with full screen apps. And then when I swipe back up here, we also have start picture and picture automatically. So those are the different settings that we have with Stage Manager. Now, the last thing I want to show you, I mentioned this in the Windows video as well when I talked about the windowed app mode. You're going to see that we have our three dots in the upper left-hand corner of each window. When I tap on the other window here, we have our three dots. If you're coming from a Mac, you're going to see that this looks very familiar. When I tap on it, what I'm able to do is close the window. That's the red X. I can minimize that. It'll put it into the dock. And then I can also make it full screen. So on the iPad, we have the same options as we do on the Mac when it comes to those windows. On top of that, if we long press on it, we have the option to move and resize our windows as well as fill and arrange them. And if the app supports it, we can even add another window in there. So when I go over to multitasking and gestures, I long press on the three dots. I'm able to move and resize, fill and arrange, and add another window. I just wanted to throw that in there. If you watch my video on windowed app mode, you probably already learned this, but I thought I'd throw that in there for the people that haven't watched that yet. So that's basically how we work with Stage Manager on the iPad. Like I said in the introduction, this is a ramped up version of the windowed app modes. In addition to opening up our apps into different windows, having access to the menu bar, what we can also do with Stage Manager is we can group them together in our recent apps. This is going to show on the left side. So now what we're able to do is group our social media apps together, our productivity apps together, things like that. So that's how we work with Stage Manager on the iPad. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can subscribe to my channel. You can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, I also have a couple of other options for you. I have dance tutorials. With dance tutorials, not only do I have more videos, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. This is a membership-based site, so when you become a member, what I'll do for you is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You'll have access to that AI assistant as well as my classes and webinars. If you're not a fan of subscriptions or memberships, I also have another option. This is Dan's Online Courses. This is located at dansonlinecourses.com. With Dan's Online Courses, basically what I have are different courses there. As of this recording, I have one course on the iPhone, but this video, as well as many other, will be included in a new course on the iPad, and I also plan on including one on the Mac. These are one-time purchases. They're not subscriptions. So when you purchase that course, you're going to get all the videos for that course. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member or purchase a course, you are also helping support a small business. Check out danstutorials.com or dansonlinecourses.com for more information. And thanks for watching.